half a decade old now. Looking back to where we've come from, seeing how much we have achieved, it feels less of a hobby to be proud of, but more of a legacy to resolve. Cutlass has touched many lives in the last 5 years. Staff and cadets come and go, they will always take the loyalty of Cutlass with them. Last year's speech spoke about unimaginable losses, challenging times that we just put behind us. This year, I would like to start on a much more positive note. Because as much as yes, there's been challenges, continuing battle against limited funds in the shortest of time, I am happy and proud to say that this year has been one of the best years for this unit. We've had more successes than we could ever hope for. This year, I'd like to focus on legacy and think about what we leave behind. What difference we make to people's lives, better or for worse. And how Cutlass has become so much more than any one person. I'd like to talk about real life heroes. We always talk about successes and how great we are, and yes, we are the best. We are the most committed and we provide such high quality of training. But what does that mean? I would suggest that Cutlass is a lot more than that. We are a professional body of people who share an ambition that's leaving a lasting positive effect on young lives. To make young people's lives just that little bit better. In the moment, whilst still at cadets, and also long afterwards, and they're still using the skills that we taught them, and looking fondly back upon us. So with that in mind, let's all raise your glasses to the cadets. Pass and present.
The cadets. Pass and present.
It's no secret that to achieve our goals, we get a lot of support along the way. Not just by our members and relatives, but also externally to the unit. To our supporters that consistently fight our corner and with us on. And special thanks to the Royal British Legion for continued support and have us in their minds at all times. And to the Bird Foundation, we find their time to be generous contributions which made the unit strong and alone has enriched so many young lives. So thank you. I mentioned legacy and heroes. And without a doubt, one important man has always been our thoughts. Saying goodbye to Mr. Graham Hall has got to be one of the hardest things this year has ever done. He was one of our biggest supporters, and I hope you'll make him proud. Please raise your glasses as I'd like to toast to Ashton Friends.
Ashton Friends.
I firmly believe that every person that comes into contact with Cutlass continues to hold it in their hearts. We stand for morals, for high standards, integrity and pride. In the current world that we face, where children are made to grow up so quickly and stand against such dangers out on the streets, where children fear for their safety on a daily basis and see no way through. I am faithful beyond doubt that Cutlass will guide them and give them relief from pressures and fear. That is the legacy that I want to leave behind. That is the goal of this unit and the shared dream across every member sat in this room now. So if you do nothing else tonight, please spend the time and listen to our committed staff. Shake their hand and thank them. Because the important work they do with zero financial reward is beyond amazing. This unit goes from strength to strength because it's people. The organisation of training, camps and events, the challenges of funding, staffing and logistics does not fall notice. On behalf of Craig and myself, I'd like to thank you all. I'd like to end this speech now. Quote. Plato said, a hero is born among 100, a wise man is found among 1,000. For Cutlass, they have a unit full of them. Well, a paraphrase, obviously. Probably more apt is a quote from a man called Wynne. Another quote from Michael Mitchell. My belt holds my trousers up, the belt loops hold my belt up. So who is the real hero? That reminds me of Cutlass. The heroes you see are not always the ones you really need to thank. But one thing is for certain, not all heroes wear capes. But anyone who does anything for the betterment of children are a hero to me. Thank you for coming tonight and please dig deep, help raise much needed funds to keep the studio afloat. So thank you.
Good evening, my lord, lieutenant. Ladies and gentlemen, honoured guests and members of the mess. Cheers for you. What can I say that I haven't said the previous years? By the way, you may be right now.
Sorry, just not ask for a moment for it.
What can I say that I haven't said previous years? Well, we have the same old faces, a lot of fresh new blood to be sacrificed as well. And I want to start with the things that we haven't had to deal with this year. HQ, I haven't had to deal with them. I had six champions of 2019. We haven't had anyone crash into a tree, which is always a bonus. We haven't had anyone hit a motorcycle, Jen. We haven't had a member of staff proposition in the wood space. And as far as as far as I know, we've not got any more pregnant, which is always a bonus. What has happened this year? Well, we went to the Imperial War Museum, that happened. We went to hit in the bunker again. We pranced around HMS Belfast as if we owned it. We got to embarrass ourselves on the nuclear assault course, and not forgetting that we had a senior member of staff be a complete nut in Pakistan over steel cable. Spend hours trying to get it out. Did you buggy your chassis up? Please bear in mind that this wire was covered in a high-vis coating. It's been there longer than I've been alive. So, 18 years. And also, our commanding officer, Lieutenant Taylor, has decided he doesn't want a typical officer's butter, like myself, and has lost 36 stones to get to his final weight of 16. I would like to clap you on that, but I'm sure you've already done it previously. We've had highs and lows, we've had cadets leave us, but we've also had faces rejoin us as staff. And as of this moment, we're getting ready for our cadets to advance next week, so fingers crossed they might have learned some stuff. But I'm not hopeful I've met them. Things to look forward to in the future. Lots of opens and holidays, but within cadets, we have a trip to HMS Bristol in the pipeline. We're looking at making targets for specialisation. With peak week coming up, where cadets will be given the opportunity to blow each other up and to learn new skills, which they probably ignore. And of course, as we grow, we're looking for support to find a place to call home. Because if ET can do it, so can we. But on a serious note, everyone here has given up their time to help this unit, and I appreciate that. Especially when we all know that time is limited and eventually we will all die. So it's nice to take this time to remember that we do this for those children who turn up, forget to pay their subs, eat us out of Nutella, wind us up, make us angry, watch them progress, become adults and productive people, or just normal would be a win. Thank you, enjoy your night, stay safe, and I'd like you all to raise your glasses. That was it.
That in mind, I would like to raise a glass and toast to new families.
To new families. This afternoon, I mentioned I was going to be here. She did advise me I would be attending the most informal formal event that I would ever like to be here.
The only kiss
box. I think we're now getting into the realms of too much detail. This is probably a law that says you can't do that anymore.
I don't know. I work in a jail.
Well, I was saying. But just a bit serious for a few moments. We've heard from speeches that have already preceded my few words about the great work that you do with young people. And I think it is absolutely astounding. Growing up, I think the modern environment is incredibly difficult for the young people in society. They're faced with a number of challenges, they're faced with a number of threats, a number of dangers, a number of distractions, and all of them have the potential not to grow up to be the model citizens that we would like them to be. So I think the fact that we have movements like Your Movement who get involved with young people at a young age to encourage them to get involved in constructive and positive activities, such as engineering, archery, map reading, all the skills that I think allow them to become problem solvers. They may not see that at the time that you're teaching them and working with them, but you are teaching them how to tackle problems. And those will be the life skills that they need when they become adults, and whether they go into higher education or go to the world of work to become the leaders of society in the year ahead. Those will be the crucial lessons that I hope that they remember. Now, of course, none of that can happen without the dedicated time and devotion that you have chosen to give to young people. And for that reason, as Her Majesty's personal representative in Leicester, I was very keen to come here to offer you my thanks, to applaud you personally, and to wish you all the best over the next few years. I'm delighted to be here to help you celebrate the fifth anniversary of T.S. Cutlass. I'd like to wish you the best for the next 5 years, and I'd like to toast those next 5 years and beyond. The next 5 years will be on the T.S. Cutlass. I hope you all enjoy the rest of the evening. There is another 2-hour addendum that I could give to this speech, but I have been asked by Matt and Craig not to, because I think Craig wants to take over shortly, but enjoy the rest of the evening. And I do look forward to seeing you all again in the very near future. Thank you.
Sergeant Matthews
literally gives up more time than sometimes even himself for this unit, and he does some of the most boring jobs simply that me and I want to do, or more like that I can't do. So, Darren, I'd like to thank you on behalf of the unit for your commitment. Whatever this person is, he's always better close than some of you. So, for the second year on the trot, I'd like to award this to Colour Sergeant Taylor. He's not a morning person, but he can definitely dress well. The Newcomer Award. So the Newcomer Award is for a member of staff that has joined us this year and has made the biggest difference within the unit. I'm afraid that's not that outfit, I hope I should.
This is how we got over.
This one was a relatively easy one, meant we've not had that many newcomers. So I'm out. I'd like to award you this note. You've worked really hard for Sabre, and it's definitely getting there. Okay. The next three awards were not decided by Craig or myself. These were voted on. Now this one is the committee award, the youth management committee. So each member of the committee voted, and I am proud and pleased to announce that I can award this note to Kerry. I think every member of the committee will agree that the committee has not always been the strongest within this unit. Yeah, however, over the last 6-9 months, the committee played a massive part in pushing this unit forward. And I believe that it's down to the leadership Kerry shows. So thank you. Cadets of the Year. So all the staff voted on which cadet they felt they put the most effort in. They might not be the best at what they do, but they put maximum effort in. So I'd like to bring this to the year.
Green Marlon, Lieutenant, Cadets and Gentlemen, Honey Guest, and Hands of the Mess. This year has been a tough one, so the Cadets have done tremendously well. As voted by the staff, MC Bulwark voted Best Cadet for the county, and I'm representing this known as Best Cadet. Thank you.
Farm and everything.
Not like that.
So,
Okay, the officer award. Okay. Every year, the officers get overlooked. And so all of the officers voted. I'm awarding it. It can obviously not be me. So, Craig, for everything you do, it's not just a spare name that we had.
Which is strange because I voted for you.
I voted for you.
This is cool. We're better off for some vote for most.
From gnomes then. The why. No expense spared. The Lamborghini there. So the first one I'd like to then is again to put us on Taylor. I want to thank him for everything he does in the Royal Protection Commando, and he's a massive influence within this unit, so thank you. Next one I'd like to turn to is Pierre Rogers. Pierre Rogers has really teached upon our inventories, and do believe he's done a fantastic job. And sadly, our new entries have just been kind of neglected and just forced into their detachments or their divisions and forgotten about. Now, Ian, I'd like to talk. This wine is just a personal thank you from me for everything you're doing, and I hope it continues.
Yeah, I don't know.
Next one, quite me. Very new members, it's already made us laugh, it's already made good relationships with the cadets and staff. So, to be honest, that's not the top incentive. This one. See, honey, just before you go though, if you could just play some members of the best, there's a kitchen here for us.
It was here,
okay. I was thought that you would have much, much more witty reward than that.
Wondering if you had a number.
Chloe, have you seen that picture before?
Yeah.
That's who he's normally at the weekend.
Okay, another new member of staff, and again, it's actually impressed every member of staff since contact. So, Mr. Peckham, that's what we'll be giving this bottle of wine. Okay, the next person is not actually a member of staff in our unit, not a police member, but still, even though this person is not a part of our unit officially, she does a lot for our unit. From marketing, media, taking photos. I'd like to award this to April. She will be taking our climbing, our cycling, our expedition training to our next. Thank you. I appreciate how much money this costs me. I've got the expensive stuff as well. Okay, on to the committer. Claire. For all the minutes that you take. But all the minutes that you do, and I do appreciate it. I know I'm harsh, I know I put strict deadlines on getting minutes to me as quickly as possible, but you do it, and I want to thank you. So please come up with me since this one. Another committee member, quite a relatively new committee member, and has already made the committee meetings so much more interesting. Certainly attended one of them. Okay. It's more film, eh? I don't think about your, that kind of profanity. No, please come out to the phone. Let me give you a bye-bye. People don't see. Not everybody appreciates the things you do because they'll see what you do. I see what you do. I see the organisation that goes into these counties such as Belfast, which was our most successful county in recent history. So I'd like to thank you. Please want to make a proud hand. So, a bit of a backstory actually on this one. When Sonhan, don't want to study orders, when Sonhan first became a member of staff, he set a tradition that when a cadet or previous cadet turned staff, they will not be presented any wine, because that would be very inappropriate, but instead, some follow on milk. So, CI mate, please come up here. So Mouse, again, thank you too. Yeah, much appreciated. Very strong on yourselves. Thank you. A box of goodies. It's not one of those really bad shows on holiday, isn't it? Jen! Last year she got her son that she always wanted. This year she constantly takes money without even taking names who she takes money from. So I'd like to come up to the front and be presented your little cash till. And you can take part as well. Don't go away, Jen! Don't go away! I joke, obviously. I made sure I got your pins. Or some of them.
Thank you. You went for times.
PML! Here I am to take on one of the biggest tasks we've ever given to a member of staff.
Ginger babies!
That wasn't the task, okay?
The new one's not ginger. You might not be mine,
though. I'd like to thank you for everything you do, the blue jackets, and it's going to be absolutely amazing once it's finished. On a personal note, now, a lot of people won't get this, I get that, yeah. You won't understand this, but I know you ain't will.
Why is that passion fruit?
I'd like to send you this bottle of homemade passion fruit. Okay. Next on the list, very importantly, and not just because you've done with one, Mumsy. Mother, you attend this unit just to see your children more. I know. But you add great benefit. As a treasurer, you log so much money into my family, monthly account. I know it can be quite laborious. I know data entry is never exciting, but it's essential, so thank you. And I'd like you to put us in front of you presented this Yes Cutlass chart. Thank you. Okay. The next person is one of my partners in crime. Not you, Devin. Kerry. Like I said before, the leadership Kerry Sherman's this committee has changed the way we work, has pushed this unit forward, and the sheer wit she has over Darren is fantastic. Because he does everything for us. Okay? Conference engines, bullets, everything else. Okay? Kerry, I'd like to present you this bottle of gin and flowers. This one leads nicely on.
Sorry. Dear God.
You guessed it for me, Darren. Darren. Now, not the brightest. I'm joking. I'm not, obviously. On a serious note, Darren will drop everything to do such a boring task and get his hands dirty, literally, for the benefit of this unit. Yeah, I keep trying to see anything around the house and do it for me, not like that. But look, he's always there for us. So, Darren, I'd like to send you this big up. You're quite so funny. Darren, I know you struggle. So I've bought you up, build your own engine, learn how to fix them. Thank you very much. Tom, I know I've already given you a bottle of wine, pick my brother up. So, little bit of extra for you. On a serious note, I'm green jack you a lot. And last year, we met Gladys. I couldn't bring Gladys back, because Becky's here now. Yeah? But, I think she might be jealous. You don't want to know Becky, trust me. Okay? So I couldn't bring Gladys back, so I asked my friends what else is important to you. So, with that in mind, and this probably will end up at Mother's, okay? But, I'd like to present you this canvas. Because I care, because I love you, and I want to make sure that you're safe this peak week. I got you a beekeeper's net, and some bottles of insect repellent. Somebody stands with a baton on it.
Thank you. It's really appreciated. Thank you. On the couch.
Before I go on to the final presentation, I believe Craig wants to make some presentations.
I've just got the one, and that's for you.
Right.
Basically, you, as I said in my speech, you have been trying to lose a load of weight. I wanted to encourage you that last few
1,000 miles.
So, go on, where have you gone? Come here, you. Well, he can tell you not.
He's a table, can't he?
So.
Arms in shame, mate, while I'm waiting.
Yep.
I thought you lived.
It even worked. It's not been in the attic for 5 years, obviously. So, that's for you, sir.
Thank you,
Jason.
It
works?
It does, yeah.
Right, okay, I'm doing the best tonight with my niece. I don't know how I'm going to get off this now. Okay, my final presentation. Who have I left out? Last year, you saw on Space TV, you saw our music video. Now, I couldn't do the same thing again. Nothing will come close to that music video. It was genius from Craig, but I would like to present you this video. That's all the presentations from myself. I believe Terry wants to make some presentations as well. Over to you.
Thank you.
Yes, yeah.
Don't worry,
I think he's booked a book about hope.
He's great with them. Okay, that brings me to the end. Thank you all for joining us. Before we finish, I'd like to open up to the room. If anybody else would like to say a few words or make any presentations.
Yeah, so I'd like to basically, first of all, on behalf of the cadets, now they all put together a bit of money of their own.
Half of the paper sucks.
to make these for you guys. So they organised.
Well, I ain't got a pencil, I can pop my fridge out
there. So they organised, getting the photo together, they've all put their own personal messages around it. And they asked me to present it to you guys. So you've got one each. So thank you very much.
I've got more words than you.
What would you say?
It's my blood or extra blood.
So, this is from all staff and all committee. This is from everyone.
Again, I'd like to thank you personally. What's this for?
Now, second lieutenant Craig Clark. He is fragile.
Like me.
Baby monkey.
I won't say that because you can open it together. Mm. Okay.
Three, two, one. Is it the pennant? Lovely, thank you very much.
Obviously, don't want to go to the after party and get broken.
I want to go to the after party and fill them up.
But all my credit's joining us, so it's all good.
Because I do believe last year's was almost broken.
It was broken when you got in there. No, thank you. Thank you, committee. Thank you, staff. I don't believe it when everyone says I only come here for presents. It's not true.
Come here for presents.
Yeah, and we've got four bottles of wine here, so. Who put the most in?
Who cut part of this off? So, rough drink, I'm great.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. If there's anybody else who wants to say a few words, here's your time now. Thank you. And without further ado, much to the audience, excitement, I now declare East Springs. Thank you. Relax. Enjoy the rest of the night. You want to say something, sir? Okay, so sit down.
For those who do know me, my name is Samantha Webster. I'm an officer of Cut North. I'm currently with the RMC Cyber Sea Cadets. Please don't forget. Before I joined the Sea Cadets, I spent 13 years at the Head of Cadets. The last 2 years. There was a comment quite recently by an instructor of my neck of the woods saying that independent units are no good and they don't last long, they don't have the resources. Well, this clearly shows you may not have all the resources to seek it, but you do have the resources and the right people. And all that. This is highly commendable. Okay, what you've done here is nothing short of brilliant. Okay, I'm proud of it to be here. Okay, you and your staff are second to none. And some people up north, if they even did half the things you did, okay, would be in a better situation. So I'd just like to say thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
It springs! Yes. Relax! Name the bear, £2 a go, trying to get 100 names. All that is, just two goes each, go for it. If you want to name the bear, please go see a member of the committee and they'll sort you out. Thank you.
There is a vodka in that fashion room, isn't there? You gave me the only knowledge.